Messiah comes to take us home. May His praise be found in you. Israel, beloved, Ephraim, my son, how my heart will thrill to hear you say, Messiah has come. Oh, my brothers, hear this word. Turn again to worship Adonai. This year you will know. Shalom, shalom, Jerusalem. Peace be to you. When Messiah comes to take us home, may His praise be found in you.
When the cloud of God
wakati wingu la Mungu
came down
lilishuka
into the house of the Lord
katika nyumba ya Bwana,
what is the message to the church?
Ujumbe ni upi kwa kanisa?
Number one, in a hurry.
Jambo la kwanza kwa uharaka.
Number one,
jambo la kwanza.
He comes to the church.
Anakuja kwa kanisa.
To give the church.
Kupatia kanisa.
Direction.
Mwelekeo.
Direction.
Mwelekeo.
Do you remember Israel?
Je, unakumbuka Israeli?
When Moses was leading them.
Wakati Musa alikuwa akiwaongoza.
Through the wilderness.
Kupitia kwa jangwa.
The same cloud, same.
Wingu lile lile.
Had to appear.
Ilibidi lionekane.
Why?
Kwa nini?
Because when God
kwa sababu wakati
looked
Mungu
at the children of Israel,
alipotazama wana wa Israeli,
He saw them
aliwaona
going around like this,
wakizunguka hivi,
like people without direction,
kama watu wasio na mwelekeo.
He was shocked.
Alishtuka.
He asked, are these the people I have just delivered? Akauliza, by power.
Je, hawa ndio watu ambao nimewakomboa na nguvu zangu?
They sounded.
Walionekana.
To have forgotten the massive power.
Kana kwamba wamesahau nguvu kubwa.
That delivered them from Egypt.
Ambazo ziliwakomboa toka Misri.
And yet.
Na ili hali.
He had a mission and vision for the house of Jacob.
Alikuwa na huduma na maono kwa nyumba ya Yakobo.
That one day.
Ya kwamba siku moja.
The Messiah.
Masihi.
The Lamb of God.
Mwana kondoo wa Mungu.
Would come through them.
Angetoka kupitia kwao.
And deliver humanity.
Na kukomboa binadamu.
But when he looked at them.
Lakini alipowatazama.
He realized.
Alikundua.
It is as if they did not understand the mission and vision of God for them.
Nikana kwamba hawakuelewa huduma na maono ya Bwana kwao.
Confused and lost.
Wamechanganyikiwa na wamepotea.
They were saying,
walikuwa wakisema,
aha, this time,
wakati huu,
what time is it?
Ni wakati ni saa ngapi sasa?
This time in Egypt,
wakati huu Misri,
I would be eating a huge pot of meat.
Ningekuwa nakula tu chungu kubwa cha nyama.
And huge cucumbers.
Na matango makubwa.
And pots of fish.
Na viungo vya samaki.
I am thirsting here.
Niko na kiu hapa.
We are struggling to find water.
Tunangangana kupata maji.
But this time in Egypt.
Lakini wakati huu kule Misri.
I would be drinking.
Ningekuwa na kunywa
the sweet waters of the Nile,
maji matamu ya mto Nile,
until the Egyptians write poems about the sweet waters of the Nile.
Hadi wa Misri wakaandika mashairi kuhusu maji tamu ya mto Nile.
The Lord heard all that.
Bwana alisikia yoyote.
He heard them.
Aliwasikia.
Saying.
Wakisema.
That this man Moses.
Ya kwamba huyu mtu Musa.
We are not even sure of him.
Hata hatuna uhakika kumhusu.
Let us find for ourselves a leader.
Wacha tujitafutie kiongozi.
To take us back.
Aturejeshe.
They said.
Alisema.
They said.
Walisema.
This God.
Huyu Mungu.
We don't understand.
Hatumwelewi.
Let us make for ourselves a God we can see and touch.
Wacha tujitengeneze Mungu ambaye tuweza kumuona.
The Lord heard all that he heard.
Mungu alisikia hayo yote.
And when he heard.
Na aliposikia.
He said.
Alisema.
Allah. What are these people saying?
Hawa watu wanasema nini?
Because of the gravity.
Kwa sababu ya uzito.
Of the fact.
Ya swala.
That their hearts.
Kwamba mioyo yao.
Were now inclined to Egypt again.
Sasa ilikuwa imerejea Misri tena.
The God had himself.
Mungu ilibidi yeye mwenyewe.
Had to come. Down himself.
Ilibidi ashuke chini yeye mwenyewe.
To give the house of Jacob.
Kupatia nyumba ya Yakobo.
Direction.
Mwelekeo.
Direction.
Mwelekeo.
The book of Numbers chapter 9.
Kitabu cha Hesabu sura ya 9.
Verses 15 to 23.
Mstari wa 15 hadi 23.
I am not reading it. You can read it. Tomorrow we will read it.
Sitaisoma, unaweza isoma. Kesho tutaisoma.
Because of time.
Kwa sababu ya wakati.
I have only 25 minutes.
Niko tu na dakika 25.
Numbers chapter 9.
Na Hesabu sura ya 9.
Verses 15 to 23.
Mstari wa 15 hadi 23.
You see the following.
Unaona yafuatayo.
You see a very disobedient Israel.
Unaona Israeli ile ile ambayo isiyotii.
And then
alafu
when the cloud, the same cloud, this cloud,
wakati wingu lile lile
comes down,
lilishuka chini
on the tent,
katika hema.
Then you see a different Israel.
Basi unaona Israeli tofauti.
You see two different Israels.
Unaona Israeli mbili tofauti.
Because he says in Numbers chapter 9.
Kwa sababu anasema katika Hesabu sura ya 9.
15 to 23.
15 hadi 23.
He says.
Anasema.
And when the cloud settled.
Na wakati wingu lilitulia.
They encamped.
Walitulia.
When the cloud lifted.
Wakati wingu lilinuka.
They packed up their virago.
Walichukua virago vyao.
They packed up their bags.
Walichukua virago vyao.
And they left with the cloud.
Na wakaondoka na wingu.
And he says at the end of it.
Na unaona mwishowe.
That whether the cloud settled for a day.
Ya kwamba ikiwa wingu lilitulia wakati wa mchana.
Israeli would encamp for a day.
Wangetulia kwa siku moja.
Whether it settled from evening till morning.
Ikiwa lilitulia kwa kuanzia jioni mpaka asubuhi.
They would encamp from evening till morning.
Basi wangetulia, wangekaa pale kambini kutoka jioni mpaka asubuhi.
Whether it settled.
Ikiwa lilitulia.
For years.
Kwa miaka.
Or for a year or months.
Ama miaka ama miezi.
Whatever the time.
Wakati wowote ule.
They would observe.
Wangetii.
Then he says.
Alafu anasema.
In that way.
Kwa njia hiyo,
Israel obeyed.
Israeli ilitii
the command of God.
Amri ya Mungu.
Through Moses.
Kupitia Musa.
Now.
Sasa.
When I look at the church today.
Ninapolitazama kanisa leo.
I see as if.
Ninaona kana kwamba.
The church.
Kanisa.
Is repeating the Bible.
Linarudia Biblia.
If you look at the pastors today,
ikiwa utawatazama wachungaji leo hii,
their hearts,
mioyo yao,
are inclined to other things,
imeungamanishwa na vitu vingine,
other than the sheep,
ijapokuwa kondoo,
other than the rapture,
ijapokuwa unyakuzi,
other than glory,
kando na utukufu,
other than the kingdom,
kando na ufalme.
That's why,
hiyo ndio sababu,
you hear a lot of scandals,
unasikia kashfa nyingi.
When you look at the church,
unapolitazama kanisa,
because of what I said about the pastors,
kwa sababu kile nilichosema kuhusu wachungaji,
you see the following.
Unaona yafuatayo.
The women walk almost naked in church.
Wanawake wanatembea karibu nusu uchi kwa kanisa.
And the pastors don't bother to rebuke.
Na wachungaji washughuliki kukemea.
The young men,
vijana wachanga,
walk naked in the church.
Wanatembea uchi kanisani.
With sagging trousers.
Wakiwa na longi ambazo karibu zinaanguka.
And the pastors don't care to rebuke.
Na mchungaji hajalishi kukemea.
The evil, immoral people come to church to teach messages of immorality.
Watu wa ovu wanakuja kanisani kwa sherati kufundisha jumbe za usherati.
And the church,
na kanisa,
does not care to stop them or rebuke them.
Haijali kuwasimamisha ama kuwakemea.
When you look at the church,
wakati unaliangalia kanisa,
you see,
unaona,
that the very Egypt,
ya kwamba umisiri ule ule,
from which the Lord delivered her in a mighty way on the cross,
ambao Bwana aliwakomboa kwa njia kubwa sana kupitia msalaba,
by power,
kwa nguvu,
miracles,
miujiza,
and the wonders of the cross,
na miujiza ya msalaba,
is the very Egypt,
ndio ile umisiri,
that she is inclined to,
ambayo ameegemea,
and going back to,
na kurudi kwayo.
And the Lord is saying,
na Bwana anasema,
I cannot believe you are doing that.
Siwezi nikaamini unafanya hivyo.
I cannot believe that.
Siwezi kuamini.
The big cucumbers.
Matango makubwa makubwa.
And the Lord said,
na Bwana akasema,
when I called you,
nilipokuita,
there is no single day,
hakuna siku hata moja,
I plan to humiliate you,
nilipanga kukuaibisha.
Don't worry about what will I wear,
usijali nitavaa nini.
What will I eat,
nitakula nini.
Where will I sleep,
nitalala wapi.
He says,
anasema,
even the birds,
hata ndege,
in the air,
wa angani,
they have no store granaries,
hawana magala,
where they keep their harvest,
ambapo wanaweka mavuno yao,
but your God in heaven,
lakini Mungu wenu mbinguni,
he
Mungu wa
feeds mbinguni, them,
anawalisha,
on a daily basis,
katika nyanja za kila siku.
And he says,
na anasema,
how much more you,
na je ni zaidi kiasi gani ninyi,
my servants,
watumishi wangu.
Why?
Kwa nini?
And he says,
na anasema,
seek ye first the kingdom of God,
utafuteni kwanza ufalme wa Mungu,
and his righteousness,
na uhaki wake,
and his kingdom,
na ufalme wake,
and everything else,
na kila kitu kinginecho,
will be given to you,
kitapewa kwenu.
What is this faithlessness I see in church?
Sasa hii ni nini kutoaminika, kutokuwa na imani ambayo naona kwa kanisa?
They have no faith, and they are teaching about faith.
Hawana imani na wanafundisha kuhusu imani.
Oh yes.
Ndio hiyo.
The Lord is saying,
Bwana yuasema,
that at this hour,
ya kwamba katika saa hii,
the pastors,
wachungaji,
must now follow the leading of God.
Lazima sasa wafuate mwongozo wa Mungu.
He says,
anasema,
that everybody,
ya kwamba kila mtu,
in the Bible,
katika Biblia,
whenever they encountered the glory of the Godhead,
wakati wowote walikutana na utukufu wa Mungu Baba,
two things changed,
mambo mawili yalibadilika,
their identity changed right away,
kitambulisho chao kilibadilika papo hapo,
and then their life's mission, ministry,
alafu huduma yao ya maisha,
changed instant,
ilibadilika papo hapo.
If you don't change,
ikiwa hautabadilika,
you will be the first person I meet,
utakuwa mtu wa kwanza nitakayekutana na yeye,
who encounters the glory,
ambaye amekutana na utukufu,
and doesn't change,
na habadiliki.
The glory has come,
utukufu umekuja,
to give the church,
kulipatia kanisa,
direction,
mwelekeo.
And he's saying,
na anasema,
that Israel,
ya kwamba Israeli,
had never been this way before,
haijawahi haikuwa imekuwa katika hiyo njia
to Jerusalem,
kwenda Yerusalemu.
So is the church,
hivyo ndivyo ilivyo kanisa.
She has never been to this way,
halijawahi kuwa katika njia hii,
to the rapture of the church,
kwa unyakuzi wa kanisa.
She has never been this way before,
halijawahi kuwa katika njia hii hapo nyuma.
So she surely needs the leadership of God,
kwa hivyo kwa kweli linahitaji uongozi wa Mungu,
to give her direction,
kumpatia mwelekeo.
I don't have time,
sina wakati.
I need to read the last point,
nahitaji kusoma ile hoja ya mwisho.
But before I give the last point,
lakini kabla nipeane hoja ya mwisho,
can I underscore one more thing on direction?
Je, naweza guzia jambo moja kuhusu mwelekeo?
If you read the book of Exodus 13, I don't have time now.
Ukisoma kitabu cha Kutoka 13, sina muda sasa.
This is what you see.
Hiki ndicho unaona.
When the cloud came to give Israel direction,
wakati wingu lilikuja kupatia Israeli mwelekeo,
look at what he did.
Tazama kile alichotenda.
He took them,
aliwapeleka,
with their women and children,
na watoto wao, wanawake na watoto.
There was a shortcut,
kulikuwa na njia ya mkato,
but he took a way,
lakini alichukua njia
that went straight straight and face the Red Sea like this.
Ilioenda moja kwa moja kukumbana na Bahari Shamu.
To the Red Sea.
Bahari Shamu.
How can you do this?
Unawezaje fanya hivi?
We have women and children here.
Tuko na wanawake na watoto hapa.
They rebuked Moses.
Walimkemea Musa.
How can you do that?
Unaweza fanya aje hiyo?
How can you face the sea?
Unawezaje kuendekea kwa bahari?
But listen to me.
Lakini nisikize.
When they just obeyed.
Walipotii tu.
Number one, they saw the signs and wonders of God.
Jambo la kwanza, waliona ishara na maajabu ya Mungu.
Number two, they saw the power of the God they worship.
Jambo la pili, waliona nguvu za Mungu wanayemwabudu.
Number three,
jambo la tatu,
when the sea opened and they walked through.
Wakati bahari ilifunguka na wakatembea.
Their Egyptian enemies.
Maadui zao wa Kimisri.
Were swallowed up.
Walizamishwa.
So my question to the church is this.
Swali langu kwa kanisa nilo hili.
Considering.
Kuzingatia.
That you are not obedient.
Ya kwamba wewe si mtiifu.
To the cloud of God.
Kwa wingu la Mungu.
Or considering.
Ama kuzingatia.
That you don't obey.
Ya kwamba hautii.
The cloud of God.
Wingu la Mungu.
Tell me.
Nambie.
Who will drown your Egyptian enemies?
Nani atawazamisha maadui zako wa Kimisri?
If you don't obey.
Ikiwa hautatii.
Numbers chapter 9.
Hesabu sura ya 9.
Which you have already written.
Ambayo tayari mmeandika.
Verse 15 to 23.
Mstari wa 15 hadi 23.
The key message it pulls out.
Ujumbe ambao unajitokeza pale.
The key message that the glory, the cloud of the glory brings to the church.
Ujumbe nyeti muhimu zaidi ambao wingu la utukufu unaleta.
Is obedience.
Ni utiifu.
Obedience.
Utiifu.
And obedience.
Na utiifu.
That's the same message.
Huo ndio ujumbe ule ule.
He gave Israel.
Alipea Israeli.
Can I run into one other point?
Je, naweza pitia hoja nyingine tena?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The last point, 15 minutes.
Hoja ya mwisho dakika 15.
Listen to this now.
Sikiza haya sasa.
What is the message that the cloud of Jehovah brings to the church of Christ?
Ujumbe ni upi ambalo wingu la Jehovah linaleta kwa kanisa la Kristo?
The prophecy said.
Unabii alisema.
And fulfillment happens.
Na utimilizo ukatendeka.
But now, what is the message?
Lakini sasa, ujumbe ni upi?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The message is this.
Ujumbe ndo huu.
The cloud of God.
Wingu la Mungu.
Comes to the church.
Linakuja kwa kanisa.
To distinguish his people.
Kuwatofautisha watu wake.
When Israel followed this cloud,
wakati Israeli nifuata hili wingu,
this very cloud,
wingu hili hili,
Israeli became known from then until today,
ikajulikana kuanzia wakati ule mpaka wa sasa,
by following the cloud,
kwa kulifuata wingu,
the people whose God is Jehovah.
Watu ambao Mungu wao ni Yehova.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Good morning, church.
Habari asubuhi kanisa.
The Lord has come.
Bwana amekuja.
To separate you out.
Kuwatenga.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! in the dream. He said, this is a creation of God. I knew that he's going to do a miracle of creation.
Come.
It is amazing to me.
Mulle on hämmästyttävää.
When the Lord showed you to me in the dream.
Kun Herra näytti sinut minulle unessa.
The voice of God, voice like this.
Tällainen ääni taivaasta, Jumalan ääni. Mä kohta pyörryn tässä.
Somebody will help him here.
Joku tulkaa ottamaan kiinni, tämä mies kaatuu.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Kiitos.
Pole kabisa.
Kiitos.
When the Lord showed me this in the dream.
Kun Herra näytti minulle tämän unessa.
Yes, come up.
Tule vaan ylös.
Come up.
Tule ylös.
This is crazy.
Tämä on hämmästyttävä, ihmeellistä, ihan hullua.
This is completely crazy.
Tämä on täysin hullua.
I don't know, but I am a new one.
Minä olen aivan uusi.
The power of God is here.
Jumalan voima on täällä.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Jesus on Herra.
So now, when the Lord spoke to me,
kun Herra puhui minulle,
Banza stand here, I don't want him to fall.
En halua, että hän kaatuu, seisokaa joku hänen takanaan.
When the Lord spoke to me in the dream about you,
kun Herra puhui minulle unessa sinusta,
the voice of God spoke from heaven like this, about 3 a.m. in the morning, 3 a.m.
Jumalan ääni taivaasta puhui minulle noin 3 aamuyöllä.
And he said,
hän sanoi,
this is the creation of God.
Tän Jumalan luomisteko.
And I saw myself in this meeting in the dream.
Näin itseni tässä kokouksessa.
The creation of God.
Tämä on Jumalan vastaus.
So when I came here,
kun tulin tänne,
I knew that God is going to do a miracle of creation here.
Tiedän, että Jumala tekee tällä luovan ihmeen.
Look,
katso.
He has created a column of the leg, a column.
Hän on oikein luonut uuden jatkeen jalalle.
My God lives.
Jumala elää, Jumalani elää.
My God lives.
Minun Jumalani elää.
So tell me.
Kerro vielä.
What was your condition?
Mikä oli kuntosi,
kun tulit?
Hän sanoo.
That he had problems with the back.
Että hänellä oli ongelmia selässä.
And the muscles contracted.
Ja siellä oli lihakset kireillä.
And this leg became short.
Ja tämä jalka lyheni.
Which one?
Kumpi jalka?
Became shorter.
Yes.
Se tuli tänne lyhyempänä jalkana.
Because of the muscle contracts in the lumbago problems.
Koska täällä
that I have for 30-40 years.
30-40 vuotta täällä selkäalueella lihas on ollut kiristyneenä.
35 years now.
Silloin tällöin.
What is your name? The people live on TV want to know your name.
Mikä sun nimesi on siellä live lähetyksessä, ihmiset haluavat nähdä.
Oril.
Where do you come from in Finland, because they are watching in Finland now?
Mistä tulit Suomesta?
Sweden.
Tuli Ruotsista.
But now the people in Sweden are also watching.
Myös Ruotsissa olevat ihmiset katselevat juuri nyt.
What did you say?
The people in Sweden are also watching TV7 right now. The whole world is watching TV7
right now. Koko maailma katsoo TV7 myös Ruotsissa juuri nyt.
The only thing I can say is that
ainoa, mitä
try
sanon,
to believe in on Jesus.
Yrittäkää
open up for him.
Hän avautukaa hänelle. Se on aina. Hän on ainoa tie.
Miracles.
Ihmeitä.
Hallelujah. Did you hear that?
Kuulitteko tämän?
So now the leg.
Nyt se jalka.
Remove the shoes.
Ota kengät pois jalasta.
I want to see what you the legs that were short.
Tuo jalka, joka oli
this
lyhyt.
Leg was short.
Tämä jalka oli lyhyt.
Meaning he was walking.
Se oli siis tämmöstä se kävely.
Like that or something.
Tämmöstä oli kävely, eikö niin? Se oli tämmöistä.
I was going like this morning.
Minä kävelin näin tänä aamuna.
This morning.
Tänä aamuna.
This morning.
Tänä aamuna vielä. Oh, halleluja! Yes!
Este é grande milagre que aconteceu aqui. She had one leg shorter than the other. The Lord had just created. Pé era curto do que outra. A perna era curta do que a outra. O Senhor fez uma criação aqui. Milagre de criação. There is more, my Lord. There is more. Because one leg was shorter than the other, she had the problem here on the pelvis, and she had the pain also on the spine.
Can you say that in your in
diga em português. Fala em português.
Because of the short.
Fala tudo em português.
Devido a uma perna.
I felt the Lord touching my pelvis and straightening me. Yes, and stretching it. Yes, and this. Veja minha filha, And this week she has even exams to prove it.
You felt the hand of the Lord.
Você sentiu a mão de Deus?
Está na minha coluna.
Yes, he was straightening my back and my pelvis.
Sim.
Tava a tocar e a endireitar. Yes, I felt him, you know, stretching my back and pulling it. Yes.
Como?
E aí ele estava puxando.
Eu senti endireitando, porque devido a uma perna mais curta que a outra, o quadril fica lado mais alto que o outro. E agora eu senti Deus endireitando a minha coluna.
Because one leg was shorter than the other, you know, I was feeling God now stretching and even straightening everything. Yes, estava a sentir pouquinho de dor no momento, não é?
Did you feel like a cold, touch you something cold or what? Give us some description.
É algo frio, quente, o que é que tu tocou?
Da,
era uma mão fria, como é que foi?
Quente, muito quente.
Very hot, very hot.
Muito quente.
E como é que você conseguiu saber que está feito?
Porque eu senti a minha postura sendo endireitada. Antes eu tinha que ficar na ponta de um pé para poder endireitar a coluna. E agora eu sinto que eu não preciso. Eu estou com os dois pés no chão e a coluna.
Before I had to be on the heels of the other feet than the other,
And now I felt that I'm really down here. Vem aqui. Aqui. Isso é, tira o sapato, tira o sapato. Muito poderoso. Muito obrigado, minha filha. Agora os pés estão direitos? Estão direitos, né? Agora não estás de pé, está apoiando sobre um.
Não, certo agora.
O Senhor ainda está a criar. De todas essas curas, mas esta agora. E ali a outra vez. Isso é poderoso. Quem te conhece? Quem te conhece? Quem conhece você?
Quem? Pastor.
Pastor Maurício. Conhece ela? She works for the government. She's very known in Campo Grande. Diga-me. Será que alguém sabia da sua condição?
A minha família.
My family.
O médico.
The doctor. And my family. Estão aqui?
Infelizmente não.
Não, não, they didn't come.
They're watching on TV somewhere.
Estão, that's the live TV. Live TV, my name. Yes.
So you come and talk to them.
Pode vir e falar com a sua família aqui?
Tell them what the Lord has done.
Diga-lhes o que o Senhor fez.
Senhor me curou. O Senhor curou a minha coluna, curou minha perna que era menor do que a outra. O Senhor Jesus curou para honra e glória do Altíssimo Deus. Em nome de Jesus.
The Lord has healed me. I had a leg shorter than the other. I had a problem on the pelvis. Only the Lord healed me for the honor and glory of the Lord Jesus.
Vida normal a partir de agora. Em nome Jesus.
Now from today I have a normal life in the name of the Lord Jesus.
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Vai e dá testemunho. No governo. Diga-lhes que Jesus é Senhor. E Ele está voltando agora.
My Lord,
meu Senhor,
this woman,
essa senhora,
ever since she was born,
desde que ela nasceu,
one leg was shorter than the other,
um pé era curto do que o outro,
and she could not stand straight like this,
e ela não conseguia ficar de pé assim.
But today when you are praying,
mas hoje quando estava a orar,
she felt the leg pull three times.
Ela sentiu, o pé foi puxado
and
três vezes.
Stand straight,
agora o pé foi puxado e agora está de pé. Os dois pés estão iguais agora.
You are the person I announced from Kenya.
Você é a pessoa que eu anunciei do Quênia.
And in the pastor's conference I announced.
E na conferência do pastor eu anunciei.
Even today I said here.
Mesmo hoje eu disse aqui.
That you removed your shoes.
Que você tirou o seu sapato.
Amen. Now, the Lord Jehovah El Gibor, the mighty God, well, he has spoken with me again this past night. And in that conversation, the Lord spoke with me about the massive revival that is coming to Angola. I see also some, I don't know if it's a woman or a man, because I see the legs I see, mature legs. That are barefooted, they are healed and they remove shoes and they are now barefooted. They are able to step down. And they can now perfectly step down on the ground.
You come to me.
Vem aqui, vem aqui.
So these are the legs the Lord was talking about.
Esses são os pés que o Senhor estava a falar acerca.
Can you remove your shoes?
Tira os sapatos.
Because I kept saying I see mature legs.
Porque eu tua vez eu vejo pés maduros. É isso que eu estava a dizer.
And face this direction.
E faça essa direção.
Thank you so much.
Muito obrigado, muito obrigado. Fica aí.
Oh, these are the legs, right?
Esses são os pés.
I was even about to draw them at night yesterday.
Ontem eu estava a ver isso ontem à noite.
So talk to me. What
Fala
was your
comigo.
Condition?
Qual era a tua condição?
Eu acho quando fui criança tive, acho que o início de paralisia, mas tinha afetado apenas o pé esquerdo. E o pé esquerdo era ligeiramente mais curto que o pé direito. E eu quando tivesse de pé, não podia ficar muito tempo de pé assim direito, tinha que estar nessa posição. E aquela hora quando o profeta estava a orar, fiquei de pé nessa posição, comecei a sentir um estalo.
Since she was a baby, she had a problem. My parents were saying that it was a beginning of paralysis, and one leg was shorter than the other.
Which leg?
Qual dos pés?
O pé.
The left leg.
Okay, now.
Agora.
I went on radio.
Eu anunciei na rádio.
In Kenya.
A partir do Kenya.
And I said, I see someone, the Lord that healed you. Your legs are now. You are now stepping down, your legs are now equal. And I see without shoes.
E eu vejo sem sapato.
Yesterday at night I almost drew your legs.
Ontem ele desenhou os teus pés, ontem à noite.
And I'm saying that it looks like the leg was not, they are now equal.
Agora me parece, ele estava dizendo, agora me parece que os pés estão agora iguais.
And you are trying to see if they are not, you can now stand well.
E você estava a tentar ver se consegue ficar bem de pé.
In Kenya.
No Kenya.
And when I came here, I repeated it today.
E quando eu cheguei aqui, eu repeti isso hoje.
Glória a Deus.
Glória a Deus.
This leg was short, the left leg.
Este pé esquerdo era mais curto?
Sim.
Yes.
We are on this camera here.
Agora estamos aqui nessa câmera.
Now listen.
Escuta agora.
What did you feel there when the Lord touched you?
O que é que você sentiu aí quando o Senhor te tocou?
Estava sentindo um estalo aqui, como tivesse esse pé a recuar para trás, o pé esquerdo.
She was feeling like a crack being pushed, the left hand being pushed.
Being pushed by what?
Estava a ser puxado por quê?
Aqui mais ou menos em direção aos joelhos.
On the joints.
Começa assim a recuar para trás.
And then start pulling it back like this.
Why is this happening?
Por que isso está acontecendo?
In Helsinki, Finland.
No Helsinki, Finland aconteceu.
A man from Sweden came there with a short leg.
Um homem da Suíça veio lá com um pé também curto do que o outro.
And he felt the Lord pull the leg.
E sentiu o Senhor puxar o pé.
Until they became equal.
Até que se tornaram igual.
And then in Brazil.
E depois no Brasil.
You remember the woman who works for government?
Yes, my lord.
The short leg.
Havia uma senhora que era do governo, o pé o outro era curto do que o outro.
And she felt the Lord pull the hip.
E ela sentiu o Senhor a puxar a anca.
Very hard.
Assim muito duramente.
Until they are equal.
Até que foram iguais.
And now you are telling me this here.
Agora você está me dizendo isso aqui.
The Lord is visiting people.
O Senhor está a visitar pessoas, não é?
Amém. Sim.
So did you? What did you feel quickly?
O que que você sentiu rapidamente?
Diga.
O que que você sentiu?
Senti-me feliz. Fiquei muito tempo aí. Já me sentia cansado. Fiquei de pé assim. Depois eu disse à pastora: o Senhor tocou-me. Então ela diz: vai glorificar o nome do Senhor. Eu disse: acho é melhor esperar mais um pouco. Então.
Ai.
Quando eu me desloquei para ir à casa do Maio, ela viu-me andar, ao regressar, disse, não, irmã, vai glorificar todos, agora estás a andar bem.
She said she felt so happy and she was trembling. She told her sister, I feel like the Lord has touched me. And her sister told her, go and glorify the Lord.
Thank you so much. That is a wonderful thing you've done before these people here.
Isso é coisa maravilhosa que fizeste diante dessa gente aqui.
That they may know.
Para que eles saibam
that the Lord is visiting people now here.
Que o Senhor está a visitar pessoas aqui agora.
¿Qué pasó aquí? Ella tenía el pie torcido así, no podía caminar.
Y e agora está caminhando perfeitamente.
The Lord has straightened the broken
bone. O Senhor ha estirado el pie para que pueda caminar perfectamente. Amen.
Come here, baby.
She was born. She was born like that.
She was born like
ella
that.
Había nacido así.
Aleluya.
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 Come here, baby.
Tráeme, ven, bebé, ven.
Venga,
ven
por favor.
Ven aquí.
Mamá también.
Mamá también, ven.
Aleluya.
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 I had only 1.5 hours.
Yo solo tengo una hora y media.
What has happened here?
¿Qué pasó aquí?
Baby. Come and talk to me.
Ven y háblame.
Ask her, what has happened here? What's the name of the baby?
¿Qué pasó? ¿Cómo se llama la bebé?
Pierina.
Pierina.
And what, how old is this baby?
¿Y cuántos años tiene esta bebé? 7.
Put the microphone on her. How many years?
¿Cuántos años tiene ella?
7.
And what happened to the baby?
¿Qué le pasó a la bebé?
Ella tiene de nacimiento una lesión al cerebrito. Siempre camina así, con su piecito así. Sí, lo estoy llevando al tratamiento en la clínica San Juan.
And now today what happened here?
¿Hoy día qué pasó aquí?
Ella está caminando derecha un poco así.
Aleluya.
Aleluya.
The Lord straightened the leg to touch down.
El Señor le ordenó a la pierna que pueda tocar abajo.
Which means the cerebral problem is over.
El problema del cerebro se ha ido.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Look at that.
Mira eso.
Look at that.
Mira eso.
Look at that.
Mira eso.
The baby is now walking like this.
La bebé está caminando ahora así.
Straight.
La derecha.
Come, baby.
Ven, bebé, ven.
Come, baby, precious. Hallelujah. Look at the feet.
Mira,
gracias,
pie.
Gracias. Ahorita, ¿qué pasó?
Me pasó
una
elección al cerebro cuando tenía.
Bien.
¿Estás bien ahora?
Sí.
Aleluya. ¿Cómo te llamas?
Pierina.
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 Jesús te ama, ¿ok? Ask her, does she love Jesus?
¿Amas a Jesús, Pierina?
Sí.
What has Jesus done here?
¿Qué es lo que Jesús ha hecho aquí?
Ha hecho el mundo todo.
¿Qué ha hecho por ti, Jesús?
Me ha amado.
He has healed me.
This baby,
esta bebé,
is very special.
Es muy especial.
The baby said, she explained her situation.
Ella explicó su situación.
How the doctors were saying she has to be operated.
Como los doctores tenían que operarla.
And now when I asked her, what has Jesus done?
Y cuando hemos orado, he orado, Jesús ha hecho ahora.
My daughter, today you will never see the problem again.
Mi hija, tú nunca más verás ese problema otra vez.
You are going to walk normal the way now you are walking.
Tú vas a caminar normalmente, la forma como estás caminando ahora.
Because you are very special to Jesus.
Es porque eres muy especial para Jesús.
Never again will you walk like that.
Nunca caminarás así.
Walk to me, my daughter.
Camina hacia él. Camina hacia él.
Contigo.
Contigo.
Primeira vez. This is not the dog here. Not the dog, por favor. This is the baby I was looking for yesterday.
Este es el bebé que yo estaba buscando ayer.
Gracias, baby.
Muchas gracias, bebé.
Thank you, baby. This baby has walked.
Este niño ha caminado.
Look at the way the baby is walking.
Mira cómo está el niño caminando.
Venezuela. What happened to the baby?
¿Qué pasó al niño?
He
was born when he was 6 months old. So he had problems in the limbs. He used to walk, but the legs were shaking.
This leg.
The left one.
This baby, and what happened today?
¿Qué pasó?
The hand.
Y también los brazos.
Only the leg.
Only the leg.
And what happened today?
¿Qué pasó hoy?
And
the legs are all right now. Now he has firmness. The legs are firm now.
The Lord fortaleza the legs.
El Señor fortaleció las piernas.
My daughter.
Hija mía.
What you are saying, don't you think that is a very big miracle?
Lo que está diciendo, ¿no cree que es un milagro muy grande? Yes, of course.
Weak
it is.
And strong.
Débil, era débil y ahora se
levantó.
Ahora está fuerte, fortalecido.
This one is what?
It was said over the radio. She has a shortened arm, paralyzed. She's now healed.
What happened to your arm?
It strained. The Lord strained my hand.
Strengthened or stretched?
The Lord. He strained my hand.
The Lord stretched this hand. I have been waiting for this woman.
Do you
remember when I said on radio?
Je, mnakumbuka niliposema kwenye radio?
Praise the Lord, Pastor Faustin. The Lord has spoken with me about the meeting that is coming up in Kakamega. This is going to be a historic meeting. It's going to be a very, very mighty historic meeting in Kakamega. And the Lord has shown me a lot of cripples walk, blind see, the deaf hear, the mute speak, paralytics walk, the lame walk. The spinal cord injury is healed, but there's this particular healing miracle that the Lord highlighted for me again, and this is the stretching of the shriveled hand. And I think it's, if I look very carefully, it looks like it's someone's left hand. Is there the left? Let's see. I see someone's hand that the Lord is going to stretch, and I see a hand stretch, but then that means the Lord will stretch those shriveled limbs. I see the fingers stretching and becoming normal. The Lord is going to bring a miracle of creation in that big meeting of Kakamega. I see the hand stretching.
I was waiting for this hand, and the Lord showed me. He stretched it like this and the fingers like this.
Aliunyosha hivi kisha bidole hivi.
And I said,
na nikasema,
I don't know whether the Lord is going to do a miracle of creation.
Sijui kama Bwana anaenda kufanya muujiza wa muumbaji.
But I see a hand and the Lord stretch the fingers.
Nilikini ninaona mkono naye Bwana anainyoosha bidole.
Talk to me, it was short.
Ongea na mimi, ulikuwa ni mfupi.
It was short.
Mkono huo ulikuwa mfupi.
Lakini Mungu alinyo, nilisikia kama nimeshikwa na chuma hivi.
Aya, aya, aya.
She gripped like, she had gripped like a metal.
Have you heard what she has said?
Je, mmesikia kila amesema?
Can you say it in English?
Ebu iseme kwa Kiingereza.
It was like I was dead by the chuma. A metal and strength like this.
Nikana kwamba aliguzwa na chuma alafu ikaburuta ikanyorosha.
She felt
alihisi
like a metal touched that hand.
Kama ni chuma kiliguza huo mkono.
Stretched it like this.
Alafu kikanyorosha huo mkono hivi.
I was waiting for this woman. When I went back yesterday,
niliparudi jana,
after the service,
baada ya ibada,
I asked the Lord, where is that person with the hand you are going to stretch?
Nikauliza Bwana, yu wapi yule mtu mwenye mkono ambaye unaenda kunyorosha?
It was announced on radio, announced.
Na kutangazwa.
Eight times, please, prophet of the Lord.
Says that she had it, she was with her mother. And she trusted and believed God that now my hand will stretch. So she came with that thing.
We were with my mother, Mama Margaret Elule.
Alikuwa na mama yake, Mama Margaret Elule.
Elule, I told her, that is me that the Lord have said that his hand will be struck.
Nikambia mamangu, huyo ni mimi ambaye Bwana amesema tanyorosha kwa mamangu. Nguvu!
Hey! Yes!
Ndiyo.
She said,
anasema,
I listened to radio.
Nilisikiliza radio.
But I hear as if that is me radio is talking about.
Lakini nasikia kana kwamba mimi ni huyo ambayo radio inaongea kuhusu.
That is powerful.
Iyo ni ya nguvu.
She says, that I hear them, that is me they are talking about.
Anasema ninawasikia, huyo ni mimi ambayo wanaongea kuhusu.
Glory.
Utukufu.
Glory.
Utukufu.
Glory.
Utukufu.
Glory to the Lord.
Utukufu kwa Bwana.
Ay. Do this.
Fanya
hivi. Catch this.
namna gani? Hapo awali ilikuwa namna gani?
Hand was short. When I stretched it, it was like this.
Mkono ulikuwa mfupi.
Now let me show the people they are not seeing. Turn this way.
Geuka huku.
Stretch this up.
Nyosha mkono.
She's saying when she used to stretch both,
anasema,
this one could reach only here.
Anasema alipokuwa kinyosha mikono yote miwili, hii ingefika tu hapa.
Now.
Na sasa.
Ah! Ah, yeah. The Lord is God.
Bwana ni Mungu.
That is it.
Ndio hiyo.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!